Fox facing a ratings slump after its de facto executive producer lost the presidential election is leaning even more heavily into its buffet of culture war cuisine. I know it's about as predictable as someone singing Girls Just Want to Have Fun really badly on karaoke night, and it's predictably hypocritical to boot. Case in point, back in June, this guy promised to do better.
Middle-class families are the core of this country. They are our hope for the future, our only hope. And yet both parties have shamelessly abandoned them. Republicans pretend to be their champion. You know by now that they are not. Instead of improving the lives of their voters, the party feeds them a steady diet of mindless symbolic victories, partisan junk food designed to make them feel full even as they waste away. It is lunacy. We fall for it every time. And to the extent this show has participated in it, we apologize with deepest sincerity.
To the extent his show has participated in it, that's all that his show is. And his apology for any role in serving up partisan junk food was followed up with more partisan junk food.
So it's Dr. Seuss's birthday. The Biden administration is refusing to celebrate. We are celebrating, and we'll tell you why precisely. Which other holidays will they be canceling? Obviously, July 4th will be first on the list. So why are people attacking Columbus's statues? Well, who knows? You're definitely not allowed to ask. So have you ever eaten python? Some have. The python cowboy joins us next to explain. It goes without saying it tastes like chicken, so I'm not even going to ask you. But tell me how hard it is to hunt a python and how dangerous. And of course, the curricula in so many schools has taken a much harder edge since that time, from the extreme left wing to the outright totalitarian. No, ladies and gentlemen, Jill Biden is not Joe's caretaker. She isn't his nurse. She's his fully equal romantic partner. Jill Biden is not a doctor, no. Maybe in the same sense Dr. Pepper is. So we spent the last year hearing about a health crisis, a pandemic, but there are a lot of health crises. This may be the biggest one. Falling testosterone levels, which have completely reshaped our society, and falling sperm counts, which may make it impossible to continue the human race. So if you were asking someone to assess national security threats, you probably wouldn't ask George Soros, because he kind of seems like one. We're pretty sure the pronoun thing will appeal to whatever tiny group of deluded, unhappy people still believe that destroying nature's gender roles is a form of liberation. Talk about a war on nature. Kamala Harris, who, by the way, is the ex-girlfriend of Montel Williams and will be described that way forever after on this show. They've figured out that Christmas is bigger than they are, and therefore it's a threat to them. Better cancel it. And in fact, they're trying hard.
I don't think there's any doubt Biden's senile.
In the hands of Democratic politicians, climate change is like systemic racism in the sky. Joe Biden's voters really are a threat to you and your family.
In January, Fox had its worst ratings in two decades, and now it's going even further off the anti-truth rails in an effort to remedy that. Fox is going full Tucker. More outrageousness, more extreme opinion, and consider what that means. Tucker Carlson, who recently won a slander case filed against him, is not exactly a graduate of the Joe Friday School of Journalism. If you want just the facts, his show is certainly not the place to go. Just take a look at this. A federal judge wrote this opinion last year in a case that Carlson won, dismissing a defamation case against him. The judge in that case said Fox's lawyers, quote, persuasively argued the general tenor of Carlson's show should then inform a viewer that Carlson is not stating actual facts about the topics he discusses and is instead engaging in exaggeration and non-literal commentary. The judge said Fox was convincing as it made the case, quote, that given Mr. Carlson's reputation, any reasonable viewer arrives with an appropriate amount of skepticism about the statements he makes, end quote. And yet still, what he dishes out is what a huge chunk of the country is consuming as if it's the gospel. Clearly, Carlson and Fox are, to quote Demi Lovato, sorry, not sorry. So this should come as no surprise. Fox CEO Lachlan Murdoch, son of Fox founder Rupert Murdoch, telling an investment group the network is now the loyal opposition to the Biden administration. And quoting Murdoch here, the main beneficiary of the Trump administration from a ratings point of view is MSNBC. That's because they were the loyal opposition. That's what our job is now with the Biden administration. You'll see our ratings really improve, he said.